Good morning, children. Let us continue with the lesson wind, storms and cyclones. Yesterday I had explained you and we had done few activities also, isn't it? So now let us continue with the air expands on heating. Yesterday what we had learned? Air around us exerts pressure. Air expands on heating and contracts on cooling. Warm air rises up, whereas comparatively cooler air tends to sink towards the earth's surface. So this much we had studied. Now let us continue with the air expands on heating with a few activities. So on heating, the air expands and occupies more space. When the same thing occupies more space, it becomes lighter. The warm air is therefore lighter than the cold air. That is the reason the smoke goes up. So now through activities we'll see this. Take a boiling tube. Stretch a balloon tightly over the neck of the tube. You can use a tape to make it tight. So here is a experiment you can see here. Like this you have to take a balloon tied over the neck of the boiling tube. So now here in the picture you can see, what you can see in the first one, balloon tied over the neck of the boiling tube. Here this is a balloon, this is a test tube, isn't it? And here there is a boiling tube plus immersed in the hot water. This is hot water. Then here boiling tube immersed in a ice cold water, hot water, ice cold water, and this is a normal bottle. So this is a figure showing the shape of the balloon in hot water as well as in the cold water. So stretch a balloon tightly over the neck of the tube. You can see a tape. You can use a tape to make it tight. Pour some hot water in a beaker. Insert the boiling tube with the balloon in the hot water. Just now you had seen in the figure, isn't it? Huh? Observe for 2 to 3 minutes for any change in the shape of the balloon. Take the tube out. So what you have to do? You have to wait for 2 to 3 minutes. For any change, to see whether there is any change in it. So take the tube out. Let it cool down to room temperature. So what you have to do? You have to take the tube out at in which hot water is it, and you have to make it cool. How much it must be cool? Till the room temperature. Take some ice cold water in another beaker and place the tube with the balloon in cold water for 2 to 3 minutes. Observe the change in the shape of the balloon. Think and try to answer. What makes the balloon inflated when the boiling tube is placed in hot water? Inflated means air is filled in it, isn't it? Why is the same balloon deflated? Means there's no air in the balloon when the tube is kept in cold water. Can we infer from the first observation that air expands on heating? So from the first we can say that air expands on heating. In the hot water, when the air moves inside, it will be expanding. Can you state what happens to the air in the boiling tube when it cools? So here you can see it. This is a normal water, this is a hot water, and this is a cold water. This is inflated, this is deflated. So now the same, another activity is, instead of balloons, now you have to take 2 paper bags or empty paper cups. You might be having at home, isn't it? Paper bags or the empty paper cups of the same size. Hang the 2 bags in a candle. Below one of the bags, as shown in the figure. You can see it in the figure here, like this. You have to take 2 bags. Did you hear? Of the same size. You can take, instead of bags, cups also, which are made up of paper. So take 2 paper bags or empty paper cups of the same size. Hang the 2 bags in a candle below one of the bags, as shown in the figure. Observe what happens. Why is the balance of bags disturbed? So as the candle, you have to keep the bags upside down. Which is open, you have to keep it on the candle, and which is closed up. So you have to tie it for a stick both the bags, and after that you have to burn the candle. Then there will be a change in the balance of the bag. As the air, this thing smoke goes inside the bag, the other bag will be coming down. Thus, why is the balance of the bag disturbed? So the balance won't be same. There will be change in the balance of the bag. Does this activity indicate that warm air rises up? So by this activity, what we can say, we can indicate that warm air will rises up. So as the air is moving, it will rise up. As the warm air rises up, it pushes the bag above the candle. So it will push the bag above the candle. Does the disturbance of the balance suggest that the warm air is lighter than the cold air? So already we have learned how the wind will blow from the high region to the low region, and warm air is lighter than the cold air. So can you now explain why smoke always rises up? So in the last experiment also, in the last class also, air expands on heating, we had read, no, the smoke always rises up. So now we can explain why the smoke always rises up. Also, it is important to remember that on heating, the air expands and occupies more space. So what happens? When you heat, the air expands and occupies more space. When the same thing occupies more space, it will become lighter. The warm air is therefore lighter than the cold air. That is the reason that the smoke goes up. So that is the reason why the bag will be going up and even the smoke goes up. So here, this is the experiment. Hot air rising up. This is makes it go up. Now next, let us study about wind currents are generated due to uneven heating of the earth. So how the wind currents are generated? Due to the uneven heating of the earth. So now, movement of air. So air moves from high pressure zone to the low pressure zone of air. Air from high pressure zone rushes towards the low pressure zone to fill the gap. So we learned that air, the movement of air. Now we are going to learn about the movement of the air. So how the air will move? From the high pressure zone to the lower pressure zone of air. And air from the high pressure zone rushes towards the lower pressure. For what? To fill the gap in between. Thus, greater is the pressure difference, greater will be the speed of the wind, and vice versa. So if the pressure is greater, then there will be difference, greater will be the speed of the wind. So greater the pressure, the speed of the wind also will be greater. If it is slow, then this also, if the pressure is slow, then the speed of the wind also will be slow. Vice versa means opposite. So now, what are the causes of the wind movement? So the causes for the wind movement are: pressure difference in the air is a cause of differential heating. So the cause for the wind movement is pressure difference in the air is caused by differential heating. Warm air rises up because it becomes lighter. This creates an area of the low pressure below the rising air. The area of the low pressure is quickly filled in by the cooler air from around. That is how the wind movement is created on the earth. Thus, differential heating of air creates pressure difference, which makes the wind movement. So now we know what is the cause for the wind movement, because of the difference in the pressure. This is caused how? Because of the differentiation in heating. So what happens? Warm air rises up. Why it rises up? Because it becomes lighter, and this will create an area for the low pressure below the rising air. The area of low pressure is quickly filled by the cooler air from the air around, which is there, that will fill up the low pressure quickly with the cold air from around. That is how the wind movement is created on the earth. So like this, there will be a movement of wind on the earth. Thus, differential heating of air creates pressure difference. So because of difference in heating of air, this will create the pressure difference. So which will make the wind movement? Now movement of air because of uneven heating on earth. Movement of air in equatorial region. So we had already studied near the equator it's very hot and near the poles it is very cold, isn't it? In the last chapter we have studied. Now let us see movement of the air in equatorial region. The equatorial region gets the highest amount of sunshine throughout the year. So the equatorial region, what it gets the highest amount of sunshine, that is sun throughout the year. Due to this, the air near the equatorial region gets heated up. Yeah, because it is near the equator, it is very hot. So the region becomes heated up there. The air is very heated near the equatorial region. The warm air rises up and creates an area of low pressure. So what happens? This air rises up and it will create an area of low pressure. The cooler air from the higher latitudes, that is, I told near the poles it will be cold. So the cooler air from the higher latitudes rushes towards the equator to fill the gap. This results in the wind movement from tropical zones. So in this way, the air will move from the tropical zones towards the equator. Similarly, wind movement is caused in other parts of the earth. So like this, the wind movement is caused in the other parts of the earth. This was the movement of air in the equatorial region. So here what we have studied, hot air or the warm air rises up and creates the area of low pressure, and the cooler air from the higher latitudes rushes towards the equator to fill the gap. Now movement of air because of uneven heating of land and water. So in the previous chapter we had studied about sea breeze and all, isn't it? In the coastal areas the land warms up faster than the ocean surface. Warm air from the land rises up and creates an area of low pressure near the ground. So the low pressure zone is filled in by the cooler air from the ocean surfaces. This gives rise to the sea breeze. So here you can see it in the picture also. So already I have explained you this sea breeze, land breeze and all. So you know in the coastal areas what happens, the land warms up faster than the ocean's surface. So this warm air rises up and creates an area of low pressure near the ground. So this low pressure zone is filled with the cooler air from where? From the ocean's surface. So this gives rise to the sea breeze. Even we have studied about land breeze. So in the land breeze, what we had seen, during night the land cools down faster than the ocean surface. The warmer air from the ocean surface rises up and creates an area of low pressure near the surface. This is again filled by the cooler air from the land. So this gives rise to land breeze. So this is the difference between sea breeze and the land breeze. Now monsoon. The flow of moist air from ocean towards the land in summer is called as monsoon or monsoon wind. So already monsoon means, you know, what happens? It starts raining, isn't it? The weather will be changed. It won't be so hot as summer. So in summer, the flow of moist air from ocean towards the land in summer is called as monsoon or monsoon wind. So the moist air from the ocean towards the land in summer is called as monsoon or monsoon wind. The word monsoon came from Arabic word mawsim, which means weather. So the word monsoon was derived from Arabic word, that is mawsim, which means weather. The term monsoon had traditionally been used to describe the typical climate of the Indian peninsula during the rainy season. So this term had been used for what? To describe the typical climate of the Indian peninsula during the rainy season. Nowadays the term monsoon is being also used to describe the similar climate in other parts of the world. Monsoon winds carry water vapor which falls over the land in the form of rain after cooling down. So what happens, this monsoon winds, what they carry the water vapor which will fall over the land in the form of rain. How they'll form after this water vapor cooling. In India, the harvest depends on the monsoon wind because it is a major factor towards bringing rainfall in India. So already you know, if there is a rain, then only we have the crops, isn't it? Harvest season will begin. The farmers will be waiting for the rain or the monsoon. So if they get, then only they'll get the well crops and all, and they are able to give the sufficient water for the crops. Now here you can see in the picture, this is a monsoon season. Everywhere in the monsoon, what you can see? You can see the water. It rains, isn't it? Now this year in Gulbarga also you have a rain, lot of rain, isn't it? Though morning it is hot, but evening it is bit raining. So this year we are seeing much rainfall compared to other years, isn't it? So also like this, monsoon winds will carry the water vapor which falls over the land in the form of rainwater after cooling down. Then so only the farmers will be waiting for the monsoon season. They'll be praying for the rains and all, then only they'll get the good crops and yield also will be good, and so that they won't be high in the rates also for the grains and all. Now next is thunderstorm. Many a times rain is associated with lightning. You might have seen, isn't it? Before it rains, what happens? First the clouds will be, first you'll have wind, isn't it? Air, isn't it? First you'll have the winds, then clouds formation will be there, then it starts raining, then you see the lightning, isn't it? Many a times rain is associated with the lightning. The lightning will be so heavy or so dangerous that sometimes it may fall also. Trees will fall, suddenly there won't be power, so many things, so ours together will not have the power supply and all. So rain with the lightning is called as thunderstorm. So now what is the term thunderstorm means? What rain with the lightning is called thunderstorm. Sometimes only it makes the sound, there lightning, but there won't be rain, isn't it? Like that. So rain with the lightning is called thunderstorm. This happens mostly in summer. So in the summer if it rains, then only you will have more lightning. Thunderstorms occurs this happens mostly in the summer. Thunderstorm occurs frequently in hot and humid tropical areas such as India. Yeah, here usually it rains in our places and all very less. In that also if it is lightning and all, only sound will be there, will not have the rain, isn't it? So this will happen mostly in the summer like this. Thunderstorm occurs when they occur frequently in the hot and the humid tropical areas. Here now you can experience that it is hot and humid, isn't it? Daily it's so hot, though it is raining, but again humidity is there, such as India. In summer, the air rises up along with a lot of moisture. After rising up to a certain height, water vapor cools down and starts coming down in the form of water droplets. The swift drifting of water droplet creates electricity among clouds. This manifests in the form of lightning and sound. This is known as thunderstorm. So in the summer only this thunderstorm will take place. So first of all, what is thunderstorm? Rain with the lightning is called as thunderstorm. And where it happen, when it occurs in the hot and humid tropical areas such as India. So in summer what happens? The air rises up along with a lot of moisture. After rising up to a certain height, water vapor cools down and it comes down in the form of water droplets. So the swift drifting of water droplets creates electricity among the clouds. So this manifests in the form of lightning and sound. So this is known as thunderstorm. So what happens? Air rises up with a lot of moisture. Then after reaching certain height, water vapors will cool down and they come down in the form of water droplets. Then the swift drifting of water droplets creates the electricity among the clouds. So from this shows the lightning, this will form the lightning and the sound. So this is known as the thunderstorm. So now let us recall what all we have studied in this class. Okay, so yesterday also I had taken. So let us recall yesterday's points and today's points, and the remaining lesson I'll continue it in the next class. Okay, so yesterday what we have learnt in this lesson is about the cyclone of the Odisha, which had taken place in the year 1999. Not only once, there was twice cyclone in Odisha, isn't it? With the speed, wind speed of 200 kilometers as well as 260 kilometers per hour. And what we are going to study in this chapter, we are going to study about the wind, then the thunderstorm and the cyclones. Not only this, but what are cyclones, how are they formed, and why are they so destructive? These also points we are going to discuss in this lesson. So first we had learnt about air exerts pressure through activities, isn't it? Then next, high speed winds are accompanied by reduced air pressure. So here also we had done the activity to crumple a small piece of paper into the ball of size smaller than the mouth of an empty bottle. This activity we had done. Then next activity we had done the blow the balloons. Then activity 8.4, that was can we blow and lift the stripe of paper. So from all these activities, what we had learnt, we had learnt that the decrease in the pressure inside the bottle is no. So through these activities, we had seen that there is an increased wind speed is indeed accompanied by the reduced air pressure. So when there is increase in the wind speed, there is a reduction in the air pressure. This we had studied through these activities. And air moves from the region where the air pressure is high to the region where the air pressure is low. The greater the difference in the pressure, the faster the air will be moving. Then we had studied about air expands on heating. So air expands on heating and occupies more space. This we had done through the activities. So the first activity was we had taken a boiling tube. We had tied the balloon over the neck of the boiling tube, which was in the normal water, then immersed in the hot water, then the boiling tube immersed in the ice cold water. And we had seen that in the hot water it is inflated and in the cold water it is deflated. Then we had done the activity of taking the two paper bags or two empty cups of the same size, and here also what we had learnt, that the warm air is lighter than the colder air in this activity, isn't it? This experiment, hot air rises up. Then wind current are generated due to uneven heating of the earth. That is, air moves from the high pressure zone to the low pressure zone of the zone of air. Then air from the high pressure zone rushes towards the low pressure zone to fill the gap. This also we had learned today. Then causes of the wind movement. What are the causes? Is pressure difference in the air, which is caused by differentiation of heating. So warm air rises up because it becomes lighter. This creates an area of low pressure below the rising air. The area of low pressure is quickly filled by the cooler air from around. That is how the wind movement is created on the earth. This we had studied. Thus, differential heating of air creates pressure difference, which makes the wind movements. Then we have studied that movement of air because of the uneven heating on the earth. That is the movement of air in the equatorial region. So near the equatorial region, it will be very hot, isn't it? And near the poles, it is cold. So this both the air. The warm air rises up and creates an area of low pressure. The cooler air from the higher latitudes rushes towards the equator to fill the gap, and this will result in the wind movement from the tropical zone towards the equator. Then movement of air because of the uneven heating of land and water. Then we had seen the sea breeze and the land breeze. What is sea breeze? In coastal areas, the land warms up faster than the ocean surface. Then the warm air from the land rises up and creates an area of low pressure near the ground. The low pressure zone is filled in by the cooler air from the ocean surface. This gives rise to the sea breeze. This we had learned. Then what is the land breeze? During night, the land cools down faster than the ocean surface. The warmer air from the ocean surface rises up and creates an area of low pressure near the surface. This is filled by cooler air from the land. So this gives rise to land breeze. Then we had studied about monsoon. So what is monsoon? The flow of moist air from a ocean towards the land in summer is called the monsoon or monsoon wind. Then the word monsoon had come from the Arabic word mawsim, which means weather. The term monsoon had traditionally been used to describe the typical climate of the Indian peninsula during the rainy season. Nowadays, the term monsoon is being used to describe the similar climate in other parts of the world. So, monsoon wind carries water vapor which falls over the land in the form of rain after cooling down. In India, the harvest depends on the monsoon. So, most of the farmers or most of the crops depends upon the monsoon. If they have proper rainfall, then only the crops will grow well. Wind harvest depends on the monsoon wind. It is a major factor towards bringing rainfall in India. Then we had studied about thunderstorm. So what is thunderstorm? Rain with the lightning is called as thunderstorm. This will happen mostly in which season? Summer. Then thunderstorm occurs in the hot and humid tropical areas such as India. So in the summer, what happens? Air rises up along with a lot of moisture. After rising up to a certain height, water vapors cool down and starts coming down in the form of water droplets. So this swift drafting of water droplets creates the electricity among the clouds. So this manifests in the form of lightning and sound. So this will produce the form of light. Today we have finished so much. We have studied about wind and the thunderstorm. So about the cyclone, let me continue in the next class. Please read the lesson. Okay. Thank you.